excited. I'm super excited. I'm in a super weird mood today, so if this is super awkward and out there, I apologize. One, wish you JK. LOL. Haha. Hee hee. Hoo hoo. I'm gonna stop now. I'm sorry.
Hey guys, it's Jay, and today I am here with a review of Dream House by Marzia Bizogman.
I think I nailed that name. I'm not sure if it's actually correct, but let's go with it.
I received this book from the publisher for a BookTube tour, which is run by Grace over at Loving Dem Books. So all the links that are associated will be down below, so you guys can check that out if you're interested in this book. Just to let everybody know that all of my opinions are my own, and I'm giving like my honest opinion, and it's not influenced in any way because I received the book for free.
So just want to get that disclaimer out of the way.
This book was written by Cutie Pie Marzia, who is dating PewDiePie.
They're like YouTube celebrities, I'm sure you know who they are, but I've never heard of her before, and then I watched one of her videos, and like she seriously sounds like a butterfly. Like I couldn't stop watching her videos, because she's so cute, she's so cute.
And the book is on sale April 5th, so it's already out now, so if you're interested, go,
you know, buy it.
So there's also going to be a giveaway for this book, and another giveaway for a couple other YouTuber books, so if you're interested in that, wait to the end of the video and I'll let you know about those.
I'm gonna put the book down so I can do my intro.
So without further ado, let us get started! So I ended up giving this book a 2.5 out of 5 stars on Goodreads. I did enjoy it, but I also had a couple problems with it, which made me not be able to, you know, rate it any higher than that. The book is a young adult paranormal thriller about a girl whose dream house ends up becoming her biggest nightmare. This book follows Amethyst, who finds herself standing outside of her dream house one day. She realizes that a storm is approaching, and then the owners of the house, Mr. and Mrs. Bloom, come outside and offer her to come stay the night. The next morning, Amethyst finds herself alone with no signs of the Blooms anywhere, and she thinks that she needs to leave, but she also wants to stay in order to thank them for their hospitality when they return. The longer she stays, the more creepy things start to occur, revolving around the grumpy gardener Alfred and her very attractive neighbor Avery.
I don't want to hold the book anymore, so we're going to put it up here. And you know, you might be able to see it, you might not, who knows, we're going to hope that you can, because sorry if you can't.
I love that a YouTuber actually wrote a book that is not an autobiography. I think it was very refreshing change from what we usually see from YouTubers, and I think that this was a pretty good debut novel for the fact that it wasn't an autobiography, so she actually had to come up with something. The story is Marzia's debut novel, and it consists of a mixture of dreams and reality with psychological aspects all thrown into one. I really enjoyed how the chapters were set up and how the overall book was laid out. So basically, the chapters ended up being days in which Amethyst was in the house for her duration of her stay, and I just thought it was a really creative and interesting way to lay the book out. I thought that the book started off really well, and I really enjoyed it because it was kind of like you knew nothing going into it other than this house was beautiful and she loved it, and then it turns into a nightmare but you didn't know why, and it was like really exciting. But then it got to the point where the writing style just didn't sit well with me, and I found it kind of frustrating and hard to read. This was Marzia's first book, and you were able to tell based off of the writing style, which is one of the reasons why I only gave it a 2.5 stars instead of higher. I just felt that although it is her first book, just something about the grammar and all of that, I'm like a grammar Nazi, so just the way some of the grammar was laid out really bothered me. I just found that the characters in general were just very flat and boring, and they didn't really have any growth or development that came along with them. I did really like Alfred and Avery though. I thought that they were entertaining, but you didn't really get a lot from them. It was mostly just Amethyst the whole time. So I feel like if there was more character development, I would have rated the book a lot higher than I did. Basically, I found that the whole book revolved around Amethyst being hungry and then getting scared and then fainting. And that was basically the entire book. And it kind of got to the point where I was like, okay, but like,
anything else? Does anything else happen? No? No? Okay.
I found it kind of hard to relate to Amethyst because of some of the things that she decided to do. I found that her logic was kind of unrealistic. I did really enjoy the secondary characters of Alfred and Avery. They were definitely my favorite part of the story. I really, really enjoyed Alfred especially. I was able to call the ending of the book. It was kind of obvious once one certain thing was revealed in the book, but I still really enjoyed how the book wrapped up, and I thought that it was a very creative way to end it. I thought the overall concept of the book was very interesting and very creative, and I thought that it could have been really good if there was more substance to the book and more overall development of the characters, other than she was hungry, she got scared, she fainted. That was basically what I felt the whole book was. So now, what you've probably been waiting for this entire video, you've been watching me babble on, you're like,
Jay, get to the giveaway, so now I'm getting to the giveaway, okay?
The link for the giveaways is going to be down below, so you guys can check that out. Pretty sure it's the first link there, because, you know, it's the most important part. So as I mentioned, there are two separate giveaways. One giveaway is for a copy of Dream House, which there's a bunch of different entry options. It's like a rafflecopter giveaway. I believe there's a free entry, like always, and then a bunch of other options that you guys can choose and pick from. And then there's a second giveaway, which is for four different YouTuber books: Shane Dawson, Zoe Sugg, Connor Franta, and Joey Graceffa. If you purchase a copy of Dream House for yourself and email Grace a copy of the receipt that you purchased the book and there's proof to it, then you can enter to win these four YouTuber books. So the link is down below if you guys are interested in checking that out.
So yeah, check it out, win a book. Super exciting.
Alright guys, so that was my review of Dream House. Again, I thought it was a pretty interesting concept, although the writing style kind of brought it down and the lack of character development brought it down for me. But overall, I thought it was entertaining. And I just want to say thank you to the publisher and Grace for hosting the tour. It was super fun to be a part of. And I will see all of you lovely little individuals in my next video. Goodbye!
Oh my god, this is literally going to be so annoying to edit. I cannot get my thoughts together today. Get it together, Jay. Get it together.